All right. Praise the Lord, everybody. God is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercies endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom the Lord has redeemed from the hands of the enemy. What a mighty God we serve tonight. We thank God tonight. We bless the Lord tonight, because God is truly a good God. Praise the Lord. We thank God for his grace. What a wonderful thing to be in the house of the Lord tonight, to celebrate the name of Jesus and to lift him up. Praise God. We thank God tonight for his grace. We thank God for another Friday night that we are back in the house of the Lord to lift up and celebrate the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Truly, it's a blessing just to be here tonight. Amen. In the presence of the Lord. For the Bible said, in the presence of the Lord, there's fullness of joy. And at his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. And we thank God tonight for everyone that is available. Amen. Make themselves available to be in the house of God. And we thank God tonight, amen, for the pastor, Bishop Barney Brown. Amen. Lady Gail Brown, we greet you in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We greet, amen, Evangelist Beverly Smith, my wife, amen, and all the saints of God everywhere. It's a good thing to rise early in the morning and to sing praises unto our God. It's a good thing to praise him in the noontime, in the evening time, and in the early part of the morning. God is truly a wonderful God. We thank God for the saints of God that coming in. It's good to see Missionary Grace Reed. We give God praise for you tonight. We glorify God for you, and we continue praying for you and your husband. It's good to see Missionary Avery Lewis Smith. Amen. Missionary Dan Brainhan out of Nassau. God bless you today. Amen. Priscilla, Evangelist Priscilla Smith Campbell. God bless you. Amen. Evangelist Denise Denia Gillivy, we thank God for you tonight. Amen. Martina Armstrong, we are so grateful that God has allowed us to come to the house of the Lord tonight to celebrate Jesus. God bless you, Helena Stewart. We thank God for you. Martha Palmer, God bless you. Praise God, praying for you. Amen, that the Lord will preserve you and keep you. Amen. Good to see Missionary Dolores Ennis tonight, Laverne Thompson. We thank God for you tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God for Dana, the technician, tonight. Amen. We give God thanks and praise for her. Amen. God is truly a good God. It's good to see Missionary John Mathurin. Amen. Out of St. Lucia, we greet you in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Woman of God, we thank God for you. Amen. We are grateful tonight that God has spared our lives to see a day that we have never seen before. What a mighty God we serve. Praise God. It's a blessing to be a child of God. It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord, because truth be told, it could be otherwise. But God is good. Good to see Juliet Grant. Amen. We thank God for you tonight. I want to tell somebody tonight that God has a miracle with your name on it. So whatever your circumstances might be tonight, whatever your situation might be, the outcome is already set in your favor. Glory to God. And we are going to anoint tonight, you know, tonight, Friday night. Amen. We anoint you with oil, your family. And we pray the prayer of faith. Amen. And the Lord will raise you up, trusting and believing God to do something special in your life. Good to see Rosemary Campbell tonight. God bless you. Oh, God bless you, Evangelist Sheila Pettiford out of the Carolina. We give God praise for you. We thank God for grace. Thank God for the strength of God. God is a good God. All right, Sandra Perry, we thank God for you. We're going to pray right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight, God, for your grace. We thank you for your strength. We thank you, God, because it is you who had made us and not we ourselves. Pray tonight, God, that you bless our hearts, direct our spirit. Father, we pray that you let your name be glorified in this house. Show yourself strong and mighty, O God, on the behalf of them that trust you. Let your name be exalted. Let your name be glorified. Father, we trust you tonight. We believe you for great things. Those who are having challenges in their lives and going through the difficulties of time, we ask God that you strengthen them. We ask you undergird and refresh them. Help them, O God, to overcome and to live the victorious Christian life that you have planned for us to live. Father, we trust you tonight, and we know that there's nothing too hard for you. You said, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. There's nothing too hard for you. Father, we look to you tonight, and we thank you, God, because you have granted unto us all things that pertains to life and godliness. Have your way, O God. Glorify yourself, and let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. We thank God for Pastor Dorothy Campbell. Amen. Down there in Florida, along with Elder Campbell. We greet you tonight, women of God, men of God, we thank God for you. Greet Pastor Owen Gale in Jamaica, Pastor Joy, Marshall, and glory to God, Joan Williams up there in Limage. We greet you tonight in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God for General Overseer Pastor Monica Elizabeth Paul out of Nassau, Bahamas. We thank God for you. We greet Pastor Judith Wong up there in Toronto, Canada. We bless God for you. Pastor Graham down there in Florida. We thank God for you tonight, woman of God. It's good to see Carrie Williams, my God, out of Georges Valley. Amen. Another side of my family. God bless you, woman of God. We thank God for Teresa Hill tonight. We believe that God has something special for you tonight. Millicent Hewitt, we give God praise for you in Jesus' name. Well, God has been good to us, and his goodness is chasing after me. Glory to God. Let's just clap our hands and give the Lord a praise right now. God is good. Come on, clap your hands in your house and give the Lord a praise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Woo! All my days
I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake,
Lord, I thank you.
Until I lay my head.
Hallelujah.
I will sing of the goodness of God.
It's good to see, sister. Amen. Mr. Faith Holloman, God bless you. All my life you have been so good.
With every breath that I am
made, my God,
oh,
hallelujah,
of the goodness of God. I love your voice.
God bless you, Shirley Scott.
You will let me through the fire.
Hallelujah. My God, God bless your daughter. God bless you, Sophia. Glory to God.
Woo!
All my life you have been true. My God, somebody ought to sing it tonight. Ha! Glory to God. If you're to me. God bless you, Evangelist Michelle. Angela Green, God bless you.
Woo!
is running after me.
God bless you, Shanai Tenai. God bless you. Woo!
It's running out, running out to me.
My God.
And all my life you have been good, so good. And every breath that I have been,
my God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So good. As a good man, as a night call. Ah, God, thank you, Jesus. What a mighty God we serve tonight. All my life, God has been faithful. I am quite sure that everyone tonight, wherever you are, whether you're in the hospital, whether you're in your home, whether you're in your car, wherever you are, you can truly say that God has been faithful to you. And I have no doubt in my mind, no doubt in my mind, that all of us can testify to the fact that God has been good to us. And I'm so grateful tonight, amen, that I am a child of God. I don't know about you, but I'm glad I am a child of God. Why don't you put your hand on your heart and say, I'm glad to be a child of God. Amen, because a lot of things could have happened, a lot of things should have happened, a lot of things could have happened, but because I am a child of God, God didn't let it happen, and tonight we are so grateful. There are so many people, amen, who have been going through difficult challenges, especially in this time. We want you to know, amen, that we are here for you. We love you. We're praying for you. Glory to God. We're praying for Abigail that suffers, amen, that have mental issues. Amen. On the diabolical attack. We're praying for you. We're going to pray tonight for Vaughn. We're going to pray for, amen, Ranice. We're going to pray for Shannon. Amen. And Kalia. We're going to pray for Michelle Olivia. We want to also pray for, amen, Sister Linda Mercer and family. Amen. We're going to pray also for Iphrogen and family in Haiti. Amen. And we just want to pray that the family will be strengthened. We want to pray for Sean. Sean has prostate cancer. And we believe in God tonight that God is going to turn the situation around. Whatever your situation might be, whatever your problem might be, God is in control. And tonight, praise God, I'm going to go to the word before I pray for those and the requests that I have. And then we're going to give you instruction to anoint yourself with oil. Praise God. And we're going to pray for you tonight. Tonight we're going to pray, amen, not only for the families, but we're going to pray for married couples. And those of you who are going through marital problems, amen. Whether you're separated, whether you're divorced, whatever problem you have in your relationship, God instructed me, amen, to pray for you tonight that the Lord will strengthened, that the Lord will intervene and turn your situation around. My God, it's good to see Bishop, amen, Mingo, Bishop Gary Mingo. God bless you, man of God. I'm yet to give you a call to talk to you. Amen. But it's good to see you in the house of the Lord tonight. We thank God for you. Amen. And the saints of God, amen. We celebrate you tonight, man of God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank God for Miss Minister Felix out of St. Lucia. God bless you. Missionary Iona Boutas. We thank God for you tonight in the wonderful name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I have sought the mind of the Lord today. Amen. And the Lord have impressed in my heart, amen, to bring a word from him to you. Whatever your circumstances might be tonight, amen, God have a word for your situation. I preached a message a couple years ago, and there's a word for that thing. Whatever your circumstances might be, whatever your situation might be, there is a word cut, fit, and tailor-made for every situation. All right, so we're going to ask you to turn your Bibles with me, please, to Psalm 106 and verse 48. Also, Revelation chapter 22, verse 21 and verse 20 and 21. That is Psalm chapter 106, verse 48, and Revelation chapter 22, verse 20 and verse 21. God is good. All right, Psalm 106, verse 48. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel from everlasting to everlasting. And let all the people say, amen. Praise ye the Lord. Revelation chapter 22, verse 20 and verse 21. My God. Revelation 22, verse 20 and 21. He which testified these things saith, surely I come quickly. Amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. What a mighty God. Psalm 106, verse 48. I read it across the board. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel from everlasting to everlasting. And let all the people say, amen. Praise ye the Lord. He which testified these things said, surely I come quickly. Amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. I want to use for subject tonight one word. Amen. Glory to God. One word. Amen. Now, if I would borrow another title, I would add to it, let the people or let the church say amen. Everybody just lift your hand and say amen. Why? Because amen is a vital word of faith. The word amen is a vital word of faith. It is God's great word of certainty. So shall it be. And since there are many different languages spoken on this planet Earth, we know most words must be translated. However, there is one word that needs no translation because it has the same meaning in most language, and that is the word amen. Every child of God, amen, we hear and use the word amen so often that we don't realize the power, amen, this word carries. This one word, amen, carries, amen, supernatural power. It is the very last word in the Bible. The last word in the Bible is the word amen. It is the word we use at the end of our prayers. The word is amen. This word amen sends a message to the adversary. Send a message to hell saying it is final. Send a message saying God has the last say. He sends a message that he is the final in revelation. He's the final revelation in life. When God reveals something, then, amen, you've got to understand that the revelation carries the weight of God's authority behind it. And there is no higher authority than the authority of God's power. And once God opened his holy mouth, amen, the matter is settled. And that's why it is something that God does. And when God speaks, creation says amen. What does this word amen mean in depth? Child of God, it is the last word in the Bible, and it is God's last word on his word. Yes, the word amen is God's last word on his word. It means surely. It means truly. It means firmly. So it is. So be it. Many, amen, use this word and use it lightly, but it also means may it be fulfilled. This word amen, amen, it means may it be so. Why? Because when God says something, it is what it is. That's it, and that's all. So as a child of God, you've got to understand the power of this word, amen, has two parts to it. The first part is we are in agreement with what God has just said. Amen. So when they said amen, it puts you in agreement with what God has just said. That's why the Bible said that he that have an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. Word of God said forever, O God, thy word is settled in heaven. This one word, amen, carries a meaning in two parts, amen. And the second part, amen, it explains the why we pray to our Heavenly Father. It means, amen, we absolutely acknowledge God's authority. When you say amen as a child of God, it simply means that you, amen, acknowledge, amen, God's authority. You acknowledge, amen, God's power over all the events in your life. So when you say amen, it's not just a word, a loose word or a religious word, amen, that you choose to say amen because the preacher tells you to say so. When you say amen, amen, hey God, it means we absolutely acknowledge God's authority. We absolutely acknowledge God's wisdom. We absolutely acknowledge God's power over the events in our lives. Amen. And that is why at the end of Psalm 106 verse 48 in the scripture we read tonight, when the people said amen, they were also acknowledging God's authority. They was also acknowledging God's wisdom. They were acknowledging God's power. Amen. All agreeing to give God great praise to the Lord, the God of Israel. And they shout, amen, so be it. So I want you to understand, child of God, when we say amen all the time, amen, but usually it does not even think about it. So many times we say amen, but usually we never sit down and think about it. We always just look at it from a surface level. But glory to God, and most of the time we treat the word amen, Minister Hans, amen, sort of like a punctuation mark. Sometimes we just use it as a cliche. But as I was studying the word of God today, tapped into the mind of God, my spirit captured the revelation of the powerful word, one little word, amen. Glory to God, I found out that Jesus himself is the great amen. Yes, I said it, I found out that Jesus himself is the great amen. Our God, Revelation chapter 3, verse 14, that these things said the amen, the faithful and the true witness, the beginning of the creation, amen, of God. What is he saying here? That Jesus is the great amen. So amen is just not an abstract word. Amen is a person. So when you say amen, you say Jesus, because the Bible said these things said the amen, the faithful and the true witness, the beginning of the creation of God. And you and I know that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and all things were made by him, and without him there was nothing made that was made. When God created the heaven and the earth, creation stood back, angels stood back and said amen. So our amen says, God, we agree. Our amen says, God, we accept your commands. Our amen says, God, we believe you answer our prayer. Glory to God. And God's amen says, I want your attention. God's amen says, he is the great I am God. I come to tell somebody tonight that God himself is the great amen. God's little word with a great big meaning. God said in his word that all my promises in him there are yea and amen, and to the glory of God the Father by us. So every child of God, you've got to understand there's more to the word amen than just a cliche. Because we say our prayer and then we say amen, it is just means okay. I come to tell you, it means more than okay. It means more than your prayer is over. Glory to God. But amen means a whole lot more than that. Amen. Glory to God. And the more we look at this little word, is the more we see how important it really is. The word amen is found 78 times in the English Bible. Glory to God. The first time we see it is in the Old Testament in the book of Numbers. And the last time we see it is in Revelation chapter 22 and verse 21. When we say amen, we are declaring our trust and our commitment to our God, who has demonstrated his faithfulness. When we say amen, we tell the devil that God is in control, that God is totally and absolutely in control. Our amen are very important. Amen for what you say to God. And God, we agree. So when you open your mouth and you say amen, you're saying, God, we agree. I come to tell you in here, when you say amen, you're saying, God, you're the sovereign God, you're the supreme God, you are the almighty God, the Alpha and the Omega. You are the God, the first and the last, with the beginning and the ending. You are the great I am, God that I am. Somebody shout amen. Glory to God. When you say amen, you agree with the word. You agree with the word of God. When you open your mouth and say amen, we agree with what God says and what God is about to say about you. We agree with what God said about himself. Somebody lift up your right hand and say amen. Glory to God. We agree with what you're doing, God, and what you're about to do in our lives. When you say amen, the devil got to back up. The devil got to move out of your way, because you're saying great God. You're the great God. I heard Isaiah said, his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Somebody shout amen. I've come to tell you it here. He's still a healer. He's a doctor in the sick room. He's a lawyer in the courtroom. I heard the Bible said he was wounded for my transgression, and he was bruised for my iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. Somebody said amen. And with his stripes we are healed. I don't know about you tonight, child of God, but I come to say amen to the word of God. For I am what I am by the grace of God. It doesn't matter what the devil said. It doesn't matter what the Satan said. And your circumstances is saying it's subject to change. When God said it, glory to God, creation bowed and said amen. I don't know about you, child of God, but I heard God said, my thoughts of you are good thoughts. They are thoughts of peace and not evil, that you might have an expected end. Glory to God. And creation says amen. It doesn't matter who likes you and who doesn't like you. If God said it, amen. I come to tell you in here tonight that God is still God, and he cares about you. He cares about your situation. The Bible says the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to the cry. Amen. Let the devil know that I am a child of God. He was wounded for my transgression. Glory to God. Somebody shout amen. Let the devil know that the joy that you have, God give it to you, and the devil can't take it from you. Somebody shout amen. Tell the devil I'm going higher, because this is 2021. The day is here of the open door, and there's a shift in my season. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going higher in God. I'm going higher. Now when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, because I know that God is on my side. And if God be for us, who can be against us? Why don't you clap your hands and say amen, amen. I'm going higher in God, amen. I'm coming out of the cave, amen. I'm coming out with power. I'm coming up with a new anointing, a fresh oil, fresh fire. Somebody shout amen. Clap your hands and say amen, amen, amen. Let the devil know it is final. Somebody shout glory to God. Hallelujah. Lift up your hand right where you are and shout amen. Glory to God. Let the church amen. Glory to God. I don't know about your child of God. This is your season. This is your time. I heard the Bible said, the time to favor Zion. Ladies said, time has come. And creation said, amen. Let the devil know that you're going higher. You're going forward. A new weapon that found against you shall prosper. Amen. And that devil, that when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard. I need somebody to shout amen. Let the devil know, yea, now I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I don't have to fear no evil, but thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup running over, and surely, I say surely, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Lift up your hands and say amen. Agree with the word of God. For he that
dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Somebody say amen. Let the devil know I'm the head and I'm not the tail. But God said it, and when God said it, it's forever settled in heaven. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Doesn't matter what you look like, God has the final say. Woo! Tonight is your night for your miracle. Tonight is your night for your breakthrough. I came with one word tonight. Amen. Amen. For they that put their trust in the Lord, I shall be like Mount. The Bible said, they shall not be ashamed. They shall not be moved. They that put the trust in the Lord shall be like Mount Zion, which shall not be moved. And creation said, amen. I don't know about you tonight, child of God, but I come to agree with God, for the greater is coming. The greater is coming. New doors is about to open for you. New opportunities. I come to tell you it's not over till God says over. I say it's not over till God says over. The Bible says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. Somebody shout amen. I know it look bad right now. I know it look like your back is against the wall. I know you shed many tears. I know sometimes you felt like God has forsaken you. But I come to tell you in here, he will never forsake you in trouble. For all the Bible said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. He said, Lord, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age. And you gotta lift up your hand and agree with God and say amen. But two cannot walk together unless they agree. I agree with God, it's my time for my miracle. I agree with God, it's my time for my breakthrough. Amen. It's my time when I gotta come out of this situation, and I'm coming out with power. Amen. I'm coming out with victory. I'm coming out in power and success. Somebody shout amen. Glory to God. The last word in the book of Revelation is the word amen. Why? Because the word say amen to the word. And Jesus himself is the great amen. So whatever you're going through tonight, God said, amen. It's going to turn. It's going to change. Your circumstances is not bigger or greater than the power of God. Amen. He said, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions. Over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Amen. Oh, all the prophecies over your life, all the words spoken over your life, is about to manifest. Because when God speaks, creation says, amen. Doesn't matter what you're going through tonight. Your circumstances, what you're facing and dealing with right now, God is getting ready to turn your situation around. Amen. Amen. I feel God in this house, Dana. Glory to God. Let the church say amen. We need to come together and agree with what God said. Let every man be a liar, but let God be true. Let every devil be a liar, but let the word of God have preeminence in your life. Amen. Let that church say amen. Whatever you believe in God for tonight, lay your hands on yourself and just say amen. Glory to God. Oh God. Let the church say. Whatever God prophesied over your life, whatever God spoke in your life in 2020, and you did not see it manifest, it's about to manifest in 2021. Say amen. Glory to God. Amen. You shall live and not die. I say you shall live and not die. No matter how you feel tonight. Hey, hey, hey! Jesus! Glory to God! It looks like it's over, but it's not over till God says over. Amen. Let a church say, right in your house. Remember what I told you. The word amen is not just an objective word, not just an abstract word. The word amen is a person. Jesus is the great amen. Glory to God. When you say amen, you're agreeing with God. And God is coming to agreement with heaven. Glory to God. The impossible will become possible. All God is looking for somebody in the earth is to say amen. When God say you heal, say amen. When God say you're blessed, say amen. Let every devil be a liar. Because if God be for us, who can be against us? You need to lift up your hand and say amen. In the face of your challenge, in your face of your difficulty, grab a hold on the word of God and prophesy over yourself and say amen. I want everywhere you are right now to get your oil bottle in your hand. Get your oil in your hand. We're going to pray and consecrate this oil tonight. Glory to God. Doesn't matter what you're going through. You might be sick in your body. Have cancer, tumor. You might be struggling in different areas of your life. The provisions have been made for you. God has a miracle with your name on it. Get your oil bottle where you are right now. We're going to consecrate that oil so you can use it and anoint yourself, your family, and your children to break every stronghold, to pull down every barriers. Amen. Oh, shy. When the devil say you should have died, God say you should live. And creation said amen. Eternity say amen. Angels say amen. For God has spoken once and twice have I heard this. That power belongs to God. So let the church say. Amen. Woo! Let the church. Hayaboshanda Rabakoto Rabusu. Hallelujah. God has spoken. Hallelujah. Amen. For God is getting ready to perform the thing He's appointed, that is appointed for you. Many such things within Him, God is getting ready, because you are a victor. You've got a declaring over your life. You have to name your blessings and name them one by one. Abundance, prosperity, increase, favor, declare. Declare it over your life. I am a victor and I'm not the victim. And then you step back and say, amen. Glory to God. Somebody ought to let the devil know that you are a survivor. Once asked me, somebody asked me, and asked me, say, how I hold, how do you hold on and hold your head up so high during the difficulties of life? I told them, because no matter what comes my way, I am a survivor. I'm not a victim. And I come to tell somebody here tonight, you can hold up your head high in the midst of trouble, in the midst of difficulty, because you're not the victim. You are the survivor. You are the victor. So let the church say amen. Somebody shout amen. Sometimes you have to experience things that you don't understand, so just so that God can bring you to the place where He needs you to be. But never doubt the season that He has you in. Just say amen. Tonight the Bible said, glory to God, that all the people of God says amen. And then He said, what to praise ye the Lord. For the Spirit and the bride take a bush and a yabashata. Ah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And He which testified these things, surely I come quickly. Amen. Even so, come Lord Jesus. And then John the Revelator, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Somebody shout amen. I'm going higher. Amen. In Jesus' name. Get your oil bottle in your hand. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we honor you today. We thank you, Lord, for your word. We thank you, Lord God, because we survived the things that came to kill us. Oh God, in 2020. Lord God, we survived the things that hell has released against us. Oh God, we thank you tonight, oh God, because you're a faithful God. We thank you, Lord God, because you hear us when we call. We thank you, Lord God, because you're a great God. You're the most I am that I am, God. Lord, as we hold this oil in our hands tonight, we consecrate this oil tonight, God. Lord, that as we anoint ourselves, anoint our friends, our loved ones, oh God, let the power and the grace of God be released upon them and manifest healing in their lives and break every stronghold in their lives in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now take your oil and anoint yourself. You keep on doing it. You anoint yourself. Glory to God. Anoint your children. Anoint your grandchildren. If you're sick in your body, anoint the area that you're feeling the symptom. Glory to God. Oh, God. Come on, anoint yourself. Praise God, because God is about to take you to a greater level. Glory to God. I say, God is about to take you tonight to a greater level. I come to prophesy to somebody tonight. Oh, as you anoint yourself with oil, God is getting ready to take you to a greater level. Everything will go crazy. People will disappoint you. Friends will betray you. You will be left all alone. alone sometimes. In that very moment, God will be your only source, and He alone will take the glory and get the glory out of your life. As you anoint yourself with oil tonight, when you anoint yourself, say amen. Say in the name of Jesus, amen. Say a benediction to your affliction in the name of Jesus. As I say a benediction over your affliction tonight, glory to God, for God is getting ready to pull you out of that stuff. Amen. Hallelujah. For God is a way maker. I say God is a way maker. Amen. He provides, He supplies your very need. Anoint yourself right now in the name of Jesus. And while you anoint yourself, every now and then just stop and say amen. And say, so let it be. If you're sick in your body, amen. This is the last night I will be sick. This is the last night I will be broken. In the name of Jesus, anoint your children and your grandchildren. Come on, Dana. Ah, God. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. There's a release in your home right now. Glory to God. Some of you have short-term sickness. You have long-term sickness. But God shall tell you tonight that every sickness, every disease is broken tonight. It's broken off your life. All you've got to do is agree with me and say amen, preacher. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Woo. Yes, in the name of Jesus. I said, God is a way maker. Oh, God. Oh, God. I said, God is a way maker. He's making ways for you right now. Just by you anoint yourself with oil. Anoint your children with oil. Glory to God. And some of you, you're in a situation that seems like you'll never get out. But God is a way maker. Just know this, child of God, the God you serve is a way maker. He make a way to get it done. He make a way to fix it. He make a way to shift it. He make a way to turn it. Ah, God, even when there doesn't seem to be a way, get into the agreement with God tonight that you're going to serve Him. Maintain your faith in Him and wait on Him, because His blessings are always worth the wait and always right on time. Somebody shout amen. As though not heard, as though not known, that the everlasting God, the Creator, at the end of the earth He fainted not, neither is weary. There is no searching to His understanding. Ah, God, He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, increase its strength. Amen. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young man shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Amen. God is about to renew your strength now. Somebody say amen. God is about to lift you higher. Somebody shout amen. You're about to get your healing. Your deliverance is right on time. Glory to God. He may not be here when you want Him, but God said tonight is your night. I come to shout amen. Amen to the word of God. Amen to the principle. Amen to my healing. Amen to my deliverance. Somebody shout amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, lay your hands on yourself. Lay your hands on your children. Oh God. Oh God. Lay your hands on somebody. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I come against every sickness, every disease, every diabolical attack, every satanic resistance. I take authority over every stronghold tonight. I pull down every stronghold. I pull down every diabolical conspiracy. In the name of Jesus, I command you tonight. Amen, Satan. I command you in the name of Jesus Christ. Christ. Pick up your weapon and flee. For the Lord has given us authority to walk all over you. I come against every demonic spirit that come to cause problems and confusion and division in your home. I bind up that spirit in the name of Jesus. I break the back of the enemy in the name of Jesus. The Lord, you give us power over all the works of the devil. And tonight, Father God, I pray tonight, God, you touch your people tonight. You strengthen them in the inner man, strengthen them for the journey. In the name of Jesus, wipe away the tears from their eyes. Let them to face the future with all the fear of the failures of the past. In the name of Jesus, I release the anointing upon your life right now. I release a fresh anointing, fresh oil, fresh fire upon your life right now. In the name of Jesus, I build a wall of fire around you. I draw the bloodline of protection around you. I command your blood pressure to regulate, your heart to regulate, your sick bodies to be made whole. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. And I call it done right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody say amen 3 times. Hallelujah. Say amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Well, clap your hands and give the Lord a crazy praise. Act like it's done. Act like it's done. In Jesus' name. Jesus. Nanda Rabakata Rudyosa. Woo! Hayabo Shanda Rabakita Rudyosa. Keep on. Keep on doing it, God. Hallelujah. Jesus. Grace in. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on and sing the song tonight. Yes, Jesus. I know he never. We're going to pray for those tonight that need special prayer. We're going to pray for those who need a special touch from God tonight. We have this prayer list with all these names on it. We're going to pray for Abigail. We're going to pray for Vaughn. We're going to pray, glory to God, for Ronnie's. We're going to pray for Shannon, Benai, Kalia. We're going to pray for Michelle Olivia. We're going to pray for the Mercelli family. We're going to pray for Ephrogen family in Haiti. We're going to pray for Sean. They need special prayer tonight. Glory to God. And tonight, everyone. I want all the prayer warriors, the pastors, the bishops, the prophets. We're going to touch and agree tonight that God will break down the stronghold. We're going to pray for Deacon Courtney Edwards. We're going to pray for Amai. We're going to pray for Simone. We're going to pray for Sanya in the name of Jesus. Come on, let's pray right now, right where you are. Father God, in the name of Jesus, everyone, oh God, that is on this prayer list tonight that need a special touch from you, Lord. Oh God, that they are going through the challenges of life. I ask tonight, oh God, that you move on their behalf. You know where they live. You know their situation. You know the circumstances. And you know the battles, oh God, that they have to fight. In the name of Jesus, I pray for Shana and David. tonight, tonight. Lord God, touch her tonight. Lord God, let your power and your grace and your anointing, oh God, fight your battle for her. Turn the situation around in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we pray tonight for Ronnie's and Vaughn. Turn the situation around, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we turn tonight. Our eyes are on you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We pray for Abigail tonight, only 10 years old, oh God, under satanic attack. I command Abigail to be loose from the hands of the enemy tonight. Every diabolical spirit to be broken over her life, in the name of Jesus. I command you to be set free by the power of God. I pray tonight, God, for Michelle of Levia. Touch Michelle tonight by your power, by your grace. I pray for Sean tonight. I speak to that prostate cancer. I command it to dry up in the name of Jesus. Sean, I command you to rise and be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. I break down every barrier, every stronghold tonight in the name of Jesus. I pray for Ephraim's family in Haiti. Oh God, we're mourning tonight. Oh God, the death of the loved one. I pray that you strengthen them, oh God, and the good and refresh them in the name of Jesus. And every cry or request tonight, God, that came in, oh God, via text tonight, I rebuke the hands of the enemy. I speak liberty and victory into the lives of God's people. I break every stronghold off of you. Satan, I come against you right now. And all your tricks, I come against you. All your forces and your attack, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft spirit, every nigromancy spirit, every exorcism, every curse that is released against the people of God, I reverse it in the name of Jesus. I reverse it in the name of Jesus. I break down every barrier. I break down every stronghold. I command every spirit that come against the people of God to be broken. Ah, God, I declare Psalm 91 over the people of God in the name of Jesus. Lord God, as you position us to enter through the new door, I pray, God, that you order our steps in your ways, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. The blood, the blood, the blood, the blood of Jesus against every diabolical spirit, every prince demon, every demonic spirit, the blood of Jesus against cancer and tumor in the name of Jesus. Touch tonight, God, break down stronghold in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you and we call it done in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Lord, touch Sister Linda and her family tonight, and a good and refresher, strengthening her in her minds, strengthening her in her body, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you right now. We give you praise right now, in Jesus' name. Well, somebody clap your hands and give the Lord a praise. Amen. I say amen. Amen to your deliverance. Amen to your victory. Amen to your breakthrough. You will break through. You will break out. Somebody shout amen. Come on, we might as well praise the Lord for this now. Give the Lord a praise right where you are. Hey, 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 hey. Woo!
Oh, what shall sin on that of
the demon of the man we
are.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
What glory.
Something is happening right where you are right now. We have 10 more minutes. Something is happening right where you are right now.
When we meet our blessed Savior in the sky, redemption coming.
Ah.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God.
Oh, what a wonderful freedom. Glory to His name. I'm out of the bondage.
coming.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Come on, you gotta praise your way out. Glory to God. Yeah. Nothing can stop the plan of God for your life. Nothing. Praise the Lord. Another day, but I stand on the mountain of fire with the fire of God upon my life, and I curse that cancer. cancer in Patricia right now. I command it to die in the name of Jesus. Patricia, I command you to rise and be healed by the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus, I command Patricia to live and not die in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I thank you for the victory right now. And somebody say, amen. Somebody say, amen. Say, amen to life. Amen to healing. Amen to deliverance. Now clap your hands and come on and let's go to church. Let's have church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Something is happening tonight. Again, this another text just came in. Grace eyes have a 4-stage cancer. Ah, we come against this cancer in the name of Jesus. We break that spirit. We curse it and command it to die in the name of Jesus. I smite it with the rich red blood of Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus. I rebuke that cancer. I rebuke the cell. I curse the cell. Never to spread in your body in the name of Jesus. Grace, I command you in the name of Jesus to rise and be healed. I command the cancer to drop off, to die in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I thank you for the victory right now. I thank you for deliverance right now. I thank you for healing right now. Somebody say amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Come on, let's go to church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here is another lady by the name of Camille. Camille has a cancer and they are about to do a surgery for her. In the name of Jesus, that surgery that is cancer for Camille, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. I curse the cancer in her body. I curse it to die in the name of Jesus. I smite it with the blood of Jesus. I rebuke it. I curse it in the name of Jesus. Jesus, just as you curse the fig tree and the fig tree dry up, I curse that cancer in the name of Jesus in Camille's body. I command it to go, go, go in the name of Jesus. And Camille, I command you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to be healed. Healed by the power of God. Healed by the anointing of God. Healed by the blood of Jesus Christ. And I call it done right now in the name of Jesus. And somebody agree with me and said amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Come on, let's go to church. Let's go to church.
I'm not
poor backsliders and just came home, and God has restored them and filled them with the Holy Spirit. Oh, somebody shout amen. Somebody shout amen. And God said, in the last days, I will pour all my spirit upon all flesh. Somebody shout amen. God is bringing back the backsliders. God is bringing back those who walked away from God. Somebody ought to give the Lord a praise tonight. Ah, God, the devil has lost again. A city devil has lost again. Somebody show glory to God. Somebody show glory to God. Show glory in your house. Get him off that coach, man. Get him off your chair. Lift up your hand and start giving God a praise. Ay, 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 to know that God's plan is bigger than your past. I say God's plan is bigger than your past, and nothing can stop God's plan for your life. Are you hearing me today? I say God's plan is bigger than your life, is bigger than your past, and nothing can stop the plan of God for your life. Glory to God. For God already knows the end from the beginning. Glory to God. And he knew every mistake that you would make. And he already calculated a new route for you. I said, God already calculated a new route for you. So you can still fulfill God's best plan for your life. I see God in this house. For nothing, I said nothing can stop the plan of God for your life. Glory to God. When everything seems like it's failing apart, God, that's when God put things together just the way he wants it. So I come to prophesy somebody tonight, don't give up on God, because God will never give up on you. Glory to God. Somebody take a minute and say hallelujah. Glory to God. Ah, God, for he is controlling your destiny. I say God is controlling your destiny. Let the church say amen. For God's plan cannot be stopped by bad breaks. God's plan cannot be stopped by sickness. witness or somebody walking out on you. All of the forces of darkness cannot keep you from fulfilling your destiny, for God is controlling your destiny. Somebody said amen. I feel somebody tonight is getting an overflow. Somebody tonight is getting an overflow. Overflow of the richness of God. Overflow of the grace of God. Overflow. Somebody shout overflow. Prophesy over your life. Overflow. Speak it in your life. Overflow. Speak it in your family. Overflow. Somebody shout amen. 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 Let that devil know I got it. I got my breakthrough. I got my miracle. Amen. Amen. I got the victory. Somebody show victory. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Amen. 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 Well, give the Lord a praise like you love him. Come on, give the Lord a praise like you love him. God bless you tonight. God bless you tonight. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. I said I received my miracle. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. God bless you tonight. The blessings of God be upon you. Whatever you do, whatever you do, don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. Amen. Jesus is the greatest. Amen. Woo! Woo! Every time you say amen, you say, God, I agree with you. God, you're absolutely awesome. Amen. You're absolutely powerful. You're the only wise God. Amen. Whatever you do, don't give up on God. Tomorrow, 12 o'clock, I should be with Bishop Brown. Sunday morning, Lord have mercy, right here live. May the grace of God be upon you. I draw the bloodline of protection around you tonight in the name of Jesus. I draw the bloodline of protection around your family, around your property, around your children, around your home, your vehicle. I draw the bloodline of protection around you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And God bless you tonight. Walk good. See you when I see you. Grace, peace, and mercy be unto you from God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you tonight. Amen. Amen. Amen.